Welcome to Control Engineering Playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you stability using polar plot in this video. So one should know, when we check stability by using polar plot, this analysis is applicable only if given system is minimum phase system. So to analyze stability using polar plot, first of all, we need to identify whether given system is minimum phase system or not. Now see, minimum phase system, that is a system which is having all the poles and zeros in left half plane. So here no roots, that is there in right half plane. So for minimum phase system, all the roots are lying in left half plane. Like you see, if we have real and imaginary axis, where this is real axis and this is imaginary axis. So in this, this is our right half plane and this is our left half plane. Now if you have any roots which is there in left half plane, then system will be stable. But if you have any roots in right half plane, then system will get unstable. So if any roots are there in this plane, this is right half plane, in that case one cannot identify stability by polar plot. Right, we can identify polar plot, but we cannot identify stability using polar plot. So that is what the case which one should know before we try to identify stability using polar plot. Now how to identify stability by polar plot? So to check stability, we need to see enclosement with the critical point, and that point is -1, 0. So to check stability, we need to see critical point, that is -1, 0, and check enclosement around -1, 0 in polar plot. So I'll show you how to check that step by step, and based on that we identify whether given system is stable or not. So if this -1, 0 point is enclosed, in that case we can say system is unstable. If -1, 0 point is not enclosed in loop with polar plot, then one can say system is stable. So let us try to understand what is the meaning of enclosement with this point -1, 0 by one practical example. So let us have a polar diagram over here. So in polar diagram, as I have said, here we have real axis, that is sigma, and here we have imaginary axis, that is j omega. And in this, here we have a center, and with respect to center, distance is magnitude, and this is what critical point which we have, that is -1, 0. Now let us see a few examples in this polar diagram, so you will get to know like how to identify stability. Now you see, here I am just drawing one polar diagram, you see. Now if you observe this polar diagram, so that is happening like this, where here omega is equals to 0 and here omega is equals to infinite. And see, by this polar diagram we will have to see enclosement of this point. So if you observe, when you move from this path, it is not enclosing this point. Why? The reason is, we will have to see right side of this direction of path. So if you see right side of this direction of path, then this point is not getting enclosed by this polar diagram. So this is indicating stable system. So if that is happening, then we can say closed loop system is stable, right? Now let me give you few more cases. So here I am just taking one more case where again omega is equals to 0, that is happening from here, and here omega is equals to infinity is there. Now in this, if you have polar diagram which is moving like this, then we will have to see right side of this polar diagram. So right side of this polar diagram does not enclose minus 1 comma 0, but if you observe, this line itself is intersecting minus 1 comma 0. So this system is critically stable system. Now let me show you third case in which system will be unstable. Now you see, if polar diagram that is happening like this, where it is starting from omega is equals to 0 to omega is equals to infinite, so it is happening like this. Now in this polar diagram, you observe of right side of this graph, this minus 1 comma 0 critical point is enclosed, means closed loop system for this polar diagram, that is unstable. So stability that we identify with respect to minus 1 comma 0 point, if minus 1 comma 0 point is enclosed by polar diagram, in that case one can say system is unstable. If minus 1 comma 0 point is not enclosed, then one can say system is stable, right? So by this pink color one can see system is stable, right? As this minus 1 comma 0 point is not enclosed. Now let me explain you this stability in more detail. So one should know in control engineering what is the meaning of stability. So to understand that, let me explain you that with respect to gain crossover frequency and phase crossover frequency. So as if you have gain crossover frequency and phase crossover frequency, then you will have to see the relation in between these two. If phase crossover frequency is greater than gain crossover frequency, one can say system is stable system, right? So this is so essential to understand stability. So one should know in any diagram, it may be Bode plot, it may be polar plot, it may be root locus, it may be Nyquist plot. So in any system, once you identify phase crossover and gain crossover frequency, and if phase crossover frequency is greater than gain crossover frequency, then one can say system is stable. If phase crossover frequency is lower than gain crossover frequency, then we have unstable system. And if phase crossover frequency is equals to gain crossover frequency, then system is critically stable. So that is what the case that one should know. Now how that is happening with polar diagram, let us try to understand that. So for that, let me take one example. So here on polar diagram, we have real axis and this is imaginary axis. Now in this, if I say my polar diagram is happening like this, and this is my critical point, let us say that is minus 1 comma 0. So earlier I have told system is stable with this, as this minus 1 comma 0 point that is not enclosed over here. But how to identify that with respect to gain crossover frequency and phase crossover frequency? So for that, you see what is phase crossover frequency. So if you observe, this is real axis where angle is 0 degree. Here angle is minus 90 degree. Here angle is minus 180 degree. Here angle is minus 270 degree. Right. Now in this polar diagram, if polar diagram crosses minus 180 degree angle, then one can say that frequency is phase crossover frequency. So see, this is phase crossover frequency. And at phase crossover frequency, if I say this is my magnitude K, then my gain margin, that is 1 by K, right? That is what I have already explained in my initial video of calculation of gain margin, phase margin, gain crossover frequency and phase crossover frequency. So when polar diagram crosses minus 180 degree angle, that frequency is phase crossover frequency. And with respect to center, if magnitude is K, then gain margin is 1 by K. And in terms of dB, it will be 20 log of 1 by K. So that is how gain margin and phase crossover frequency is there. Now, to have gain crossover frequency in polar diagram, we need to have unit magnitude circle. So you see, I am just plotting unit magnitude circle in this polar diagram. So this is unit magnitude circle. Now, when you have unit magnitude circle and it is crossing polar diagram over here, so this frequency is gain crossover frequency, right? If polar diagram crosses magnitude 1, then the frequency is gain crossover frequency. And if you observe this amount of angle, so this is our phase margin, right? Now you see, frequency is starting like this. It is omega is equals to 0 over here at infinite, and omega is equals to infinite over here. So obviously, all we can see is here omega gain crossover frequency is lower than phase crossover frequency. So we can say our system is stable, right? So we can say our system is stable. And as if you have system stable, in that case, in terms of dB, your gain margin, that will be positive. It will be positive. Why it will be positive? The reason is, you can observe, this K is lower than 1. This K is lower than 1. And if you calculate 20 log 1 by K, which is lower than 1, in that case, we have positive gain margin in terms of dB. For stable system, gain margin will be positive. And for unstable system, gain margin will be negative. And you can verify that on this diagram. I'm just giving you that in your homework to understand how to understand positive gain margin and how to understand stability based on phase crossover and gain crossover frequency in this diagram. I hope you have understood this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. The reason is, your suggestions matters to me, and based on that, in future I'll be making videos which will be resolving your queries. Thank you so much for watching this video.